We're like children playing in the mud. We settle for the pain. We settle for those tears at night. But I'm here to tell you, if you would lift your eyes and look to heaven, God has so much more for you. I want to commission you tonight. Tonight is a commissioning service. We're going to mark ourselves for the rest of our lives tonight. How many of us will take our teenage years and fast them to the Lord? How many of us will take our lives right now and say, you know what, God, from this day forth, I am going to settle one thing. I'm not going to look at my issues. I'm not going to worry about the boyfriend or the girlfriend. I'm not going to worry about my status at school as far as popularity and friends. What if we said we would quit the football team so we could fast and pray? What if we said we would quit the drama group so we could give ourselves to the studying of the scripture? So that when we're 20, we have something on the inside that's burning with passion. A settledness where that pain is gone and we can walk in true liberty and call others to liberty as well. What if we did that with our lives tonight? What if we said, for this day forth, I assume to be nothing but a man or a woman that is after the heart of Christ Jesus? What if we settled tonight to lay it all down? To lay down the popularity, to lay down the image issues. Girls, I don't know how many times to tell you, you are beautiful. Stop it. Oh, how he delights in you. Stop it. You're hurting yourself. What if we lay those things down and we gave ourselves to the living God for the rest of our days? What if, how crazy would it be to say, God, I will fast my teenage years. I will take my 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 years and give them to the Lord. You guys, we're not alive very long. We're not alive very long. If the average person lives to 80, by the time you're 20, a fourth of your life is gone. If you're thinking you're going to wait till you get your career, wife and kids, you'll be about 40 and half of your life is gone. Then if you're thinking you're going to wait till the kids are out of the house, you'll be 50, 55. Your career's coming to an end, and maybe now you can enjoy life, but guess what? You only got a fourth of it left. Then you're tired and frustrated. You're 60, you're 70. You're nearing the end of your days. You got to go to a nursing home. And then what? What became of your life? Have any of you thought about what are we going to do for the next 60 years? We don't have much time. What if today we decided to make the wisest decision we can and give ourselves teenage years to fasting, to prayer, to seeking the living God with all of our heart? What if today is the day? Is anyone with me? What if today is the day that we say, you know what, from this day forth, I am going to be defined by one thing. As a lover of Jesus Christ and nothing else. What if today we decided that we're going to forget about what our success ratio looks like and we're going to look at how much we have known of the living God? What if it was based on how much we love him, about how much we care for him, about how much we know about his attributes? There is a God living in heaven who desires you. Why not give a couple years to the one who created you and do what you were created to do for a couple years? Why not? What's stopping us? What is stopping us? Let's fast our teenage years. Let's make this night. What's the date today? June 25th, 2009. June 25th, 2009, at 9 o'clock at night, we are going to make a dedication, a vow to the Lord, that we will fast our teenage years. What has sin gotten us? Nothing, right? You guys have tried the drugs, the sex, the throwing up in the bathroom. You've looked at yourself wrong in the mirror. You've tried the crying at night. That's not helping, right? See, it doesn't seem to be getting you anything. Why not give the next 5 years to the pursuit of the holiness of Jesus? Let's have the worship team come up, because I want you guys to come up to this altar and I want you to dedicate your life. We're going to dedicate our teenage years to being before the Lord. We're going to dedicate the next 5 to 6 years of our life to giving Him our hearts. There are preachers in this room that are called to preach the gospel. There are pastors that are called to help people with their sin and their shame. There are evangelists that will see regions give their lives to the living God in this room. There are great men and women in here. There could be future presidents. There could be future businessmen, doctors, lawyers. But what if our goal for the next 5 years is not those things, but it's to know God with all of our heart, and love Him with all of our heart, and love Him with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength? What if that was our goal for the next 5 years? We got the rest of our lives to be doctors and lawyers. Let's give ourselves to the living God. But whatever gain I had, I counted as a loss for the surpassing greatness of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord, for whose sake I have given up all things. Come to the altar now. If you want to do that, come now. This is a commissioning service tonight. Jesus, right now, on June 25th, 2009, we dedicate this day, O Lord, to the pursuit of Jesus Christ. We dedicate this day to the pursuit of Jesus Christ. We cast off the sin that we knew 2 weeks ago. We cast off the shame that we knew 2 weeks ago. That person that hurt and abused us is forgiven. From this day forward, we are going to move on. Our primary goal, Father, is to know the living God and pursue nothing else. Oh, give us grace right now. Ask Him for grace right now. It's not going to be an easy journey. Jesus, give us grace to pursue Your heart. We want to know the height. We want to know the depth. We want to know the width. We want to know the length of the love of Jesus Christ and what He has for us. Oh, the love of Christ which surpasses all knowledge. Oh, that You would give it to us tonight. This is Your commissioning service. I'm not going to do anything for you. You have to ask the living God right now. I want you to talk to Him. Let's cry out for understanding. Let's cry out for wisdom tonight. Let's cry out for the Holy Spirit to speak. Tonight is the night that you are going to remember. On June 25th, 2009, you dedicated your life to the pursuit of the living God.